A potential military clash between the US and China over Taiwan remains top of the Australians' fears for our regional security. It's second only to the threat of cyber attacks. That's according to the latest Lowy Institute poll that's gauged Australian perceptions about our position in the world. Joining me to go through some of the findings, Ryan Neelam, Director of the Public Opinion and Foreign Policy Program at the Lowy Institute. Thanks very much for your time. So still plenty of concern about Chinese Communist Party aggression, but a little bit tempered. We've seen the, you know, diplomatic relations thaw. Is that the attitude of Australians as well?
Well, good to be on the program. And yes, we have seen a shift in the way that Australians perceive China in the 2023 Lowy Institute poll. As you know, in the past 3 years, Australians' attitudes towards China plummeted in the context of a souring Australia-China relationship. But this year, as the diplomatic relationship has thawed, we also see a readjustment of how Australians view China. But that's not a full-scale reassessment of things. Compared to 5 years ago, trust, confidence and warmth towards China and its leader Xi Jinping still remain very low. In 2018, over half of the Australian population said that they trusted China to act responsibly. That number is only 15% today. And threat perceptions in the longer term are also still very high. Three quarters of Australians still see China as likely to pose a military threat to Australia in the next two decades.
And yet the international issue people are most concerned about now. I find this interesting because China, as you mentioned, and what's happening, we've seen real conflict happening with Russia and Ukraine. North Korea's nuclear arms are no small threat, but it's cybersecurity.
Yes, that's correct. And you're right to point out that the way Australians perceive the threats to the nation have changed over the last few years. This year, cyber attacks from other countries sits at the top of the list. And that's no surprise when you consider that in the last 12 months, we've seen three of the most significant corporate data breaches of Australian companies in Australia's history. And that's directly affected citizens who've had their medical records splashed over the dark web. So it makes sense that people would be conscious of that. And it's escalating in as a perceived threat. But what's also happened is that the perceived threats of Russia's and China's foreign policy has receded over the last year as Australians acclimatise to an ongoing war in Ukraine and also as the Australia-China relationship has stabilised.
Interesting to note, there's support for the AUKUS subs, bit of confusion about how they'll help. But despite the fact, you know, many analysts say maybe these subs make us more likely to get involved in a conflict, people support the subs, but also say Australia should remain neutral if there is a US-China conflict.
Yes, that's right. As you point out, two-thirds of Australians this year still support the acquisition of nuclear-powered submarines under AUKUS. Now, when you ask them about the impact that these submarines will have on regional stability, the picture is less clear. There's a mixed set of views on whether it will increase instability in the region, decrease instability in a region, and actually quite a large number of people don't know or think it will make no difference either way. The other result that you pointed to is that Australians don't want to get directly involved in a conflict. 56% of Australians say that if war broke out between the US and China, they would want to remain neutral. So I think that speaks perhaps to a sense that more capability is a good thing, but when it comes to the actual act of playing Australia directly into a conflict between two superpowers, Australians are a lot more wary.
Interested and, well, relieved, I must say, personally, to see that Australians, younger Australians, are coming around to democracy. There used to be older Australians really firmly of the view it was the best form of government, and younger Australians thought perhaps not. What do you put this down to?
Well, that's right. This is one of the more encouraging stories that we have in the 2023 Lowy Institute poll this year. As you say, 5 years ago, there was only 47% of Australians aged under 45 who said that democracy is preferable to any other form of government. That number has risen by 20 points to 67% this year. I think that's a reflection that Australians are conscious of how democracies have behaved, as well as how autocracies have behaved. And it sits in line with increasing threat perceptions around the region and what Russia has done in Ukraine. I think that has played very directly into how Australians view the benefit of democracy versus autocracy.
Yeah, in whatever form it might be, the sort of strongman-style Russia or the sort of Leninist bent on socialism, if you like, the reality, whatever theory you might have on it, the reality of how they work is not good places to live. And just finally, interested to note, Australian voters feel as though the government's handling things well on the US side, the alliance?
That's right. We ask a question in the Lowy Institute poll about how Australians judge the government's performance on a range of foreign policy issues. And this year, right at the top of the list is how the Albanese government has handled the alliance with the United States, which Australians obviously see as an important issue. And second on that list, the Albanese government's most highly rated on its promotion of a good international image, which speaks to the activism of this government in the region and overseas at a range of international fora.
Brian Neelam, appreciate your thoughts. Interesting study today. Thank you.
Great to be in the program. Thank you.